Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the USC Trojans and the Illinois Fighting Illini.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Fighting Illini are clearly outmatched on paper in this one, Dick. What's the key to pulling off a victory for them?
Here are a couple keys, Brad. First, reward your big men for running the court. Get them some easy buckets in transition. Second of all, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. Thirdly, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Number 21 receives the pass. And all the way on the baseline, now the kick out. He tries the three ball, way off target. The point guard handles the feed. Both teams looking to get things going here. The small forward handles the pass. That one there should have been a foul called, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact right on the defensive player.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
And up.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
They go into the low block. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline. Brad.
Down inside, Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
The center receives the ball, goes up for two.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important, with 15 to 17 feet apart.
He drains it. Moving it around the perimeter. Taken away. Defense got it after knocking it loose. The bucket counts and one.
Hey, great composure to take the foul and still get the shot off.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes it. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For two, it'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Now trying to feed the low block. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a put.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Tries for two.
I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. And now they'll bring it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Puts it up, looking for contact. And he scores despite the hack. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Trying to feed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Looking for a good shot. He gets the rejection. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Aaron.
Not getting enough motion on offense. Here they are in transition, Brad.
Dick, it's really been a while since I've seen a team shoot like this.
Hey, every once in a while, you'll get a squad that gets on a tear and simply makes your jaw drop. It's fun to watch, isn't it, Brad?
Number 32 is charged with the foul. The second team foul. He steps up to the line. He buries it. And he doesn't miss that opportunity either.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top for the bucket. Perfectly executed. This school is known for football. It's great to see that the basketball program is now getting some of that attention.
They definitely receive a lot of football support, but it's great to see the same folks at the basketball games.
They work the perimeter. He fires from long range. Off the rim and no good. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Good job defensively. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Blocks the shot. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Oh, right there. They missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. It's a special art, feeding the post. Frustration right there.
Pushes it up. The crowd really admires this young man.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
Looking for a good shot. On the inside. Jumps into the defender.
Great play to take that to the basket. STOP, this place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Stolen. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
For two. They still don't score. They work it around the perimeter. Number 21 is feeling good.
Well, he's had some success, and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now. Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
Tries for two. The layup.
That one's definitely worth a second look, Brad.
Trying to draw the foul. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
There's a double team waiting there. Puts it up, way off target. Looking to move it around the perimeter for the bucket. He drains the shot. Here's a double team. In and out. Picks off the lazy pass. Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
And a momentary look from three-point. He rejects it. The ball goes out of bounds. Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
On the outside. Number 22 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. He is going to the line. First one is good.
Makes those free throws count. Wants to go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. Defensively down on low block, and there's a steal.
A terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? No good. The ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
The first half sounds nothing as these teams remain deadlocked entering the second half.
If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. Illinois seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big and a bit of hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. The shooting guard gets the ball. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
The small forward takes the pass. The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
Dipsy dude, Dunkaroo, are you kidding me?
Both teams are looking to get something going here.
Dump it inside.
The small forward takes the feed. The kick out. He gives him the fake. Got a nice screen and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Looking for a good shot. Number 55 makes a great move to draw the foul. Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
Shot, no good. Number one with the theft. Looking for contact. He puts it in with contact and all. Dumps it in. For the deuce. He comes up empty. Moving it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. Fakes a jumper. And he'll kick it back outside. The point guard with the ball. He attempts the trifecta. He hits the shot. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
In the paint. For two. Off the rim and no good. Tries for two. The Trojans are up by four. Number 55. Pump fakes. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He intercepts it. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Working around the perimeter. He unloads a three. Goes. Gave it up. Takes away the pass. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He tries a jump hook. No good from the field. Come up with a steal, and they do. USC is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
On the dribble, gives it up. And he'll kick it back outside.
Step out on that screener.
For the bucket. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Pump fakes. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
The Fighting Illini have a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball, though?
Goes up for two. He gets the bucket to fall.
That's worth another look.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
For two. Can't get the shot to go. The center gets the pass. There's the fake, and he'll kick it back outside. Jumped in front to take it away. On the outside.
High post screen.
Basket falls despite the contact. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right time. Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two, rims out. They work it around the perimeter, gave it up, takes the shot. Oh, yes! He went for the steal in the post and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing, what a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you're a great post play. You got a chance really to win.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Number three is called for the foul. First personal foul. The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing it all now.
Hey, can you blame them, Brad? They're playing well.
The Trojans go to the line for the first time in this game. Makes the first. Just like in practice. Nothing but rim.
I like the idea of having a glass cleaner on your team. Someone who can get those rebounds.
He's got to move the ball. For two. He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Stolen. Nice job there by the defense, knocking the ball loose, then getting possession. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Picked out of the air. Oh, hard screen set on the defender. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Cross court. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Number 13 to the charity stripe. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Makes the second. The lead is 9.
9 is fine, Brad. They have to keep their composure and take good shots.
For the deuce. And off the mark. And yet another foul. With the free throw. Foul shot, no good. These kids are really struggling from the free throw line tonight.
I hope they can turn it around before it costs them the game.
He shoots from left of the circle.
They got a foul quickly here.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. One plus one if it's good. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Let's get ready to resume the action. And Dick, that puts the lead at 9.
9 points is surmountable. This is the time to start jacking threes.
Off the rim and no good. There appears to be a mismatch in the posts.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Cross court. Steals the pass. He goes with a jump hook, and in and out. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shooting the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Trojans open the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.